good peoples of the internets. My name is Femethales, and this is Project Zero, Men of Blackwater. Not to be confused with the Pirates of Darkwater, which is something else entirely. Press A. I'm pressing A. Let's see what happens when I press A. Well, load game. So, I've already done the prologue and the first drop. I sat down and I recorded it last night in, I think, two sessions, and it just wasn't good enough, guys. My video quality was terrible. Now, hopefully, it's not going to be terrible this time. I always have problems with my audio. My voice is incredibly quiet. I am very much speaking up at the moment, practically shouting, as it were. We are playing the game on normal because there is no other difficulty option. So this is Project Zero, Pirates of Darkwater, and we're just going to get into it. So prologue. A girl named Miu awakes in water. As she stands up, she sees countless bodies floating around her. The bodies stir, as if sensing Miu's presence. We can only play on normal or easy for some reason. In the vicinity of Mount Hikami, people have been mysteriously disappearing without a trace. One such girl is Miu Hinasaki. She awaits to find herself in an old, half-flooded building. Also, I do not speak Japanese, so apologies for pronunciation. It's not a language I speak or have any desire to learn. I can only do two languages, guys. And only one of them fluently, and it's not English. So anyway, this is a spooky horror game. It's got the old Japanese thing of long dark-haired women in white dresses. If that's your thing. As you can see, I've only done the start of the game. And I guess it kind of helps me out because it gives me a bit of a edge, because I know how to control this game now. There's nothing that happened before this, it just starts you in this horrifying underwater section. With all these bodies. It's quite unnerving. It's also a very dark game. I am slightly artificially brightening it on the recording. And as the album goes, I think it brightens. It is dark as shit. That's my dog. Thank you. did play, I think, what was the one that I liked? We can instant turn around by... I liked Fatal Frame 2, Project Zero 2. That's the one I've played. So this is kind of all new to me. I don't watch LPs of games I want to play. This has got a whole it's a favorite for Black Water. The pirates are going to come out of the Dark Water. Just like the pirates are going. Very unnerving. I wouldn't say it scared me. It hasn't made me jump yet. It's been unpleasant. But it's mostly because no one fucking says anything. Shit like this happens, and they just stand there and let it happen, which is not something you would do in real life. Hinasaki has disappeared. No one could hear her cries for help as she was sealed into a shrine on top of the mountain. The mountain is where the events of this story take place. We follow the fates of three men. Yuri, Len, and Kim. It's a terrifying tale of the supernatural. Obscura and her first shadow reading job begins. They've been asked to find post-mortem photographs. And again. Easy or normal. Ranking is how many points you get and I think how quick you are. I've also got points so I can buy stuff. Stone that revives you when you die. banishing trace Yuri Kozakata. Again, apologies for the pronunciation, not a language I'm familiar with. Shadow reading. There's a lot of reading in this, and I will be reading it all. Sorry, I know my accent isn't the best. Among the residents of the villages at the foot of Mount Hikami, a certain unique ability has been passed through the ages. This ability, known as shadow reading, enables the user to view the shadow or trace of someone lost in inexplicable circumstances. This is not unlike the psychometry practiced elsewhere. Yuri Kozakata accompanies Hisoka Kurosawa, a woman who possesses the shadow reading ability, to an abandoned inn on Mount Hikami. Sensing Yuri could in time become talented in shadow reading, Hisoka takes her along on an assignment. Another thing I should point out, everyone in this game is painfully gorgeous, and it's unnerving, you know, if you look like a camel's foot, like I do. Yeah, they are. It's so damn quiet.
Yuri.
I've seen Suicide Club.
Sagashimonoa Tavun Kokoyo.
That dude breaks into song with his guitar at the end and I
have no idea what happened.
So I don't know, do people like Fatal Frame? This is the last Fatal Frame game.
I've not been one
since, and apparently it's universally derided. I've been at work. Shut up, give me a break. Going to watch Arrival soon. I've been looking forward to that. So this is our first case.
少し練習しておきます。扱いは普通のカメラと同じ。構えて何か撮影してみて。
So you hold the Wii U gamepad up in front of you, and press X. And then you move around. And then you you move around with the right stick, and then you tilt the frame by using the Wii U gamepad like a steering wheel.
射影が映し出すものは隔離よ。つまり隠された世界。This
is how our camera works.
それはどこよ。死後の世界に近い。見えてしまったら、あまり深く関わらない。気をつけない。 クリオに引き込まれてしまう。この辺りは変わってしまったようね。賑やかではなかった。以前はこんな場所じゃなかった。霊場として崇められていた山は、やがて観光地になった。今は自殺の場所。
But now that I've played through a little bit, I kind of understand the controls a bit better because they're a little bit janky.
焦らないで慎重に行きましょう。さあ、中に入って。
Play the map like that. Is it? I think it's Y. Y brings up this, and then we can look at the map. Otherwise, the map, and I've already unlocked the map because I've already been here. The map will only be displayed on the gamepad, and I can't show you it in game. And this is all about exploring abandoned places. So I'm going to ignore that, and we can have a look at my camera here. I'm using my Infinite Ammo Type 7 film. upgrade our camera, increasing the distance, the output, the absorption. If you hold down the left shoulder button, she auto runs, which is weird. It's a bit weird to position her.
その写真は弔い写真。死者を弔うために撮られた写真。レンからの依頼なの。
That was me missing a scare. There was a scare and there was a ghost there, and I missed it.
他にもないか調べてほしいそうよ。
When there's stuff around, that little reticule shows up. Apparently, if you put this on a harder difficulty, this game gets a bit brutal. But it only lets you play on easy or normal at the start. So you kind of have to keep your eye out for ghosts. Our sprint. It's not the best sprint. I have a map, that's just because I played this first episode. Reminds me of Deadly Premonition. Just the random ghost enemies. Except in Deadly Premonition, you shot them with a pistol. I don't know if you played that game was fantastic for all the wrong reasons. Anyway, once we get out of this first episode, I'll get a bit more... Point the camera at her. Sometimes she poses. Not now, apparently. This is me running in deep water. There we go, now I can slightly move.
Yuri, matte. 気配を感じる。
That's why I like to record at night, so he doesn't do that shit, but...
残影は目的のものへの手がかりになる。
My voice is
too quiet.
So you have to follow the shadow. Probably just missed a ghost. The thing is, most of the ghosts that you're not fighting, they appear, and if you don't get them, you don't get them. that a shadow of the past? Yeah, so you've got to catch the ghosty things to get the points. Now, you have to hold this down. It's Mount Hikami's downfall. Here we go, reedy time. Mount Hikami has long been considered holy ground. For centuries, people have been drawn to the many sacred shrines and places of worship, as well as the natural features such as the Twilight Peak and the Pool of Purification, which have themselves been treated with great reverence. The mountain was also popular with tourists and mountain climbers for the beauty of its abundant clear waters and ancient mysterious forests. Worshippers and hikers alike used to find rest at Ishiru Manor, a hot spring resort near the foot of the mountain. Now the inn lies desolate, devoid of visitors. The mountain never recovered from a devastating landslide it suffered many years ago. The shrine road to the summit was cut off, and the flow of water throughout the mountain was altered, forever changing the landscape. New roads that were under construction had to be abandoned, and Ishiru Manor was buried under a slew of rock, resulting in numerous fatalities. Among those lost were the family of Ishiru Manor's proprietor, effectively putting an end to the business. Mount Hikami's days as a tourist destination were no more. Instead, the mountain gained notoriety as a suicide spot. Perhaps because it was traditionally a destination into which dying would venture, the mountain is now a place for those wishing to end their own lives. By extension, it's also become a place for thrill seekers interested in the occult. It's a ghost. That's how quick it is. I'm not quick enough to be captured. So you literally walk past them. He's going to ask me to go over here and then go back to another place, which is on the left here. He's going to ask me to go into here, so I'm not actually going to go into there yet. Waiting for the ghost to appear. I don't remember the scares, I just remember this first bit because I played the demo before I brought it. Now our friend has to follow us through. I've yet to manage to catch her on camera crawling through
that.
So, psychic photographs. When you look around through the lens of the camera obscura, you may notice it reacting to objects which are not normally visible. Lock on and photograph them to expose places or items you have a connection with. Find the locations from the photographs, and you may discover some clues there as well. So, I hold it in front of you. I don't know why it waits for you to say that you're holding it in front of you. I'm not using the motion control. There's the location.
Yuri.
Luckily we know it's the door. We literally just walked past. There's a hanging man. Now those ghosts don't seem to be harmful. Down to pick up, occasionally a ghosty hand will jump out and grab you. That would appear to be my dog. So all the disgusting This game is very slow paced. I mean, I've only done the first bit, as you've already seen. But even me running through it, knowing what I'm doing, it's very, very, very slow paced. This is me still trying to. So I'm facing that way, and I push back on the stick and axe. She rotates back on the stick and axe. Back on the stick and axe. I can't get her to do it. You open the door with the key on the red keychain.
この部屋にあるよね。探してみましょう。
Hold on, there's something there, yes. Phantom expose. So the camera obscura will react to items that are normally hidden from the eyes of the living. You can bring those items back to this world by photographing the place they were taken from with the correct angle and position. So we put your lock on and then woo 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 the Wii U gamepad and ka-ching. And it brings shit back into the real world. Don't worry, after this, I have no idea what's happening. This is just your basic tutorial. We got shoved in a box by some ghosts and now we're someone else.
これが依頼のもののようね。夜になる前に帰りましょう。ここはあまりいい場所じゃない。
See, that looks like a checkpoint, but when I've loaded up at, you know, hit continue game, I've had to redo the entire level again. It's a bit irritating, to say the least. He's appearing, man. Yeah. Descriptions are a bit... Descriptions are a bit not good, should we say.
今回のようなもの探しは簡単だけど、人探しは難しいわ。影見はその名の通り対象の影を見てしまう。神隠しにあった人の影は追わない方がいい。見てはいけないものを見てしまうこともある。
We'll end it here. I've got our first enemy.